I'm a VIP.
I'm a VIP.
What's a VIP?
Pinellas County is fortunate to have the VIP, Volunteers in Pinellas program. The economic downturn in recent years has caused the various county departments to rely more and more on the VIPs to continue to provide quality services residents have come to expect. Among the hundreds of volunteers is Carl Stump. Stump is a 65-year-old retired surveyor from upstate New York. After moving to Seminole, he turned to the VIP program to see if his 45 years of experience could be utilized in some way.
I determined that shortly after Christmas that I needed to do something that was rewarding for me, that brought me intrinsic reward, way to give back to the community. And I was tired of just getting up every day and looking for things to do. And having found the volunteer job list, there's tasks anybody can do, any skill level anybody has, they will find a job that will bring them a reward, and they can offer that to the county. And it's been a great opportunity for me.
At the same time Carl applied to become a VIP, Christina Pellegatti, Technical Project Coordinator for the South Cross Bayou Water Reclamation Facility in St. Petersburg, was looking at an annual report they were required to give to the Florida EPA. That report included giving the reclaimed water inventory for 7 locations in the county, including a pond at the mainland's golf course in Pinellas Park. In the past, their report had shown an unknown amount of water at the pond. When Pellegatti heard of Stump, she was pleasantly surprised to learn he could fill in the unknown water quantity with an actual number. Stump explains the method he used.
In order to determine the volume of water in here, I brought a kayak over and I had an electronic sonar device, so I was able to determine the relative differences in depth of the water. And then by using survey techniques, I was able to determine the surface area, and that combined with averaging the depth, I was able to determine that depth, yes, and the quantity of water and the volume from that.
Pellegatti says she was impressed with Stump's knowledge and the great attitude he had. Knowing he was looking to keep busy, she was able to find more work for him to do at South Cross Bayou.
Carl came to us through volunteer services and he worked with us on another project. I asked my boss, the plant manager, if we could possibly use a surveyor anywhere in the plant. And he mentioned that it would be a good idea to make sure these gates were as level as possible after all of the capital improvement projects that we were doing over here. So we were able to utilize Carl in a really great way to make sure that all of our effluent gates were level.
Pellegatti believes the arrangement is good for everyone involved.
This has been a win-win situation both for the county and for Carl. He's looking to volunteer his time, and we have really limited resources right now with all the budget cuts and trying to do the right thing as far as the community and saving money wherever we can. So it's really a win for the county and for the citizens of Pinellas County, as well as for Carl, who is looking to volunteer his time in the community.
Stump can now be found helping out at South Creek Bayou once or twice a week. He truly enjoys the fact that his talents and skills are being put to good use and finds his work there rewarding. Stump encourages anyone with time on their hands and a desire to help their community to check out the Pinellas County website.
Anyone can find on the volunteer tab of the Pinellas County website a list of jobs and tasks that suit their ability, suit their training, suit their interests, and they can contact the volunteer people directly.
In these hard economic times, it's nice to know there are people like Carl Stump willing to roll up their sleeves and help their community, not for any financial gain or recognition, but rather to simply share their talents and abilities with those who can use them, while at the same time remaining active. I'm Bob Costigan, Inside Pinellas.